Esteemed guests, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning and a warm welcome to today's event. The Bhagavad Gita is a text whose essence transcends time, space, and faith. To quote Dr. Kashyap from the introduction of we begin today's event with a felicitation of the esteemed dignitaries on the dais. It is a great honor to have someone of your personal stature, humane values, and heartwarming authenticity agree to release the books. I courteously welcome our honored guests. Thank you for gracing the occasion with your presence. It is your participation that makes this occasion truly rewarding. I'd like to take the opportunity to thank Vitastha Publications for publishing both the books, and a very special thanks to Renukol ma'am and her team who have worked tirelessly to make this event possible. Thank you, ma'am. I have been asked to introduce the books Srimad Bhagavad Gita in English and Srimad Bhagavad Gita Safal Sarthak or Sukhi Jeevan Ka Marg in Hindi. The books are a commentary on the Bhagavad Gita by Dr. Subhash Kashyap. Dr. Kashyap has written over 100 published books, many with multiple volumes, but these have been mainly in the area of political science, constitution, and law. Long back, when I was in school and my father was serving as Secretary General of Lok Sabha, I remember once asking him, "Papa, you have written so many books. Which of these is your one personal favorite?" He replied, "Well, I haven't written it yet. When I do, it'll be my last work." I got curious. "What book is that?" I asked. And he said, "A simple commentary on the Gita for the common man." When I asked him why he had not started writing it since he already had the concept, he explained that Gita is simple but not easy to understand and live by. It requires a lifetime of dedication to come to some sense of understanding, an understanding worth sharing. Well, this was more than 35 years ago. I learnt later that my father had been an ardent student of the subject of Bhagavad Gita since his early teens. In his inter-college days, he and his friends had formed a scholastic society for the study of the Gita called Gita Parishad. This was way back in 1945. The books being launched today by Honorable Vice President Sahib are the product of my father's study and practice for the last 85 years. Now, just to give you a brief idea about the books, in this commentary, Dr. Kashyap explains the meaning of each Sanskrit word in a verse, followed by the meaning of the full verse. The overall interpretation of the text of Bhagavad Gita is given at the beginning of the book, explaining each of the 18 chapters in brief. The ultimate message of this great text is that reality is one, and realization refers to the ability to see this oneness behind all differences in all beings and the entire creation. It teaches us detachment from desires that lie at the root of grief and sorrow. It conceptualizes happiness as beyond sorrow, but also beyond pleasure. It shows the paths of duty, that is karma yoga, devotion, that is bhakti yoga, and pursuit of true knowledge, that is gyan yoga, for transcending both pleasure and suffering. Gita affirms that life never dies. Individuals pass away, forms perish, egos dissolve. But the essence, the truth, life lives on. The Bhagavad Gita has many commentaries by some of the greatest men in history, such as Adi Shankaracharya, Mahatma Gandhi, Sri Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Sri Aurobindo, Paramhans Yoganand, and many others. One may ask for the justification of yet another commentary. My father says this is an attempt to make the Gita simple and practicable for ordinary men and women by an ordinary man. Well, this ordinary man, who's always been my hero, has lived 95 years of his life striving to practice the tenets of this great book in the best of times and in the worst of times. He fervently believes that Bhagavad Gita is not merely a religious text, but a manual for a happy, successful, and meaningful life. It is the common heritage for all humankind, and like yoga, should be accessible to all in a simple and understandable way. As I come to the end of this introduction, I'd like to assure respected Vice President Sir and all present here that we are doing our best to get Father to write his autobiography and shall ensure that the books released today will not be his last. Thank you.
President of India to present the very special 75th year commemorative coin to Dr. Subhashkar. I now request the Honorable Vice President of India to kindly address the August gathering.
Namaskar. Good morning to all of you. I felt blessed to sit on a chair on the right side of which we had Dr. Subhash Kashyap. A moment of my life I will never forget. I know Dr. Subhash Kashyap for 35 years. He was Secretary General of Lok Sabha, 7th Lok Sabha, 8th Lok Sabha, and 9th Lok Sabha. I was elected to 9th Lok Sabha from Jhunjhunu constituency. When I took oath, Dr. Kashyap was in the chair of Secretary General. When I was appointed chairman of a Committee on Absence of Members from the House, the nomenclature is very disturbing. friend's secretary general office in the parliament is an august office, imposing office. I entered his office to find out what does it mean. He told me, young man, a first time MP getting chairmanship is remarkable. A chairman gets all the facilities irrespective of nomenclature of the committee. विधि की ऐसी योजना थी कि मेरा और डॉक्टर कश्यप का लगाव बढ़ता ही चला गया. मेरे को मंत्रालय भी कौन सा मिला, पार्लियामेंट्री अफेयर्स. मुझे रोज आपके मार्गदर्शन की आवश्यकता पड़ती थी. डॉक्टर कश्यप ने वो जमाना देखा है जब कितना बड़ा परिवर्तन 7th लोकसभा में आया. डॉक्टर कश्यप ने वो जमाना देखा है 400 पार 8th लोकसभा में. और डॉक्टर कश्यप ने कोलिएशन भी देखी है जिसका मैं हिस्सा था. आपने कोलिएशन की पीड़ा देखी है. उस कोलिएशन से निजात 2014 में मिली जब एक पार्टी को बहुमत मिला. जितने उतार चढ़ाव हो सकते हैं सेक्रेटरी जनरल के जीवन में, वो सब डॉक्टर कश्यप ने देखे. और अब विधि मुझे कहाँ ले गई, पश्चिम बंगाल का राज्यपाल. डॉक्टर कश्यप से नाता और गाढ़ा हो गया. हर टेलीविजन चैनल, हर प्रिंट मीडिया डॉक्टर कश्यप कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल एक्सपर्ट से पूछते थे गवर्नर का कार्य क्षेत्र क्या है. आई मस्ट एडमायर हिज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मॉरलिटी, प्रोप्राइटी, हाई इथिकल वैल्यूज. ही नेवर लुक्ड एट इश्यूज from a political prism. He never acted with partisan stance. He held his views with conviction and uprightness. पर इनकी ये आखिरी किताब नहीं है. मेरा भी इनसे वो आखिरी लगाव नहीं था. मैं उपराष्ट्रपति बनने की वजह से राज्यपदा का सभा का सभापति बन गया. पार्लियामेंट्री डेमोक्रेसी में प्रेसिडेंट्स ऑफ ग्रेट वैल्यू. इसकी विवेचन करने वाले 3 महारथी हैं, कोल, सक्तर एंड कश्यप. देर इज नॉट अ सिंगल फैसेट ऑफ पार्लियामेंट्री वर्किंग ऑन विच the nation has not benefited out of his brilliance, guidance, momentous contribution. Authored 100 books more than his age. At 95, Dr. Kashyap is still going strong. We wish him good health and happiness. I invited Dr. Kashyap to the residence of the Vice President. Now I am in a new place, 6 Maulana Azad Road. He was good enough to come. Me and my wife, Dr. Sudesh Dhankar, got blessed by him. I inspired him and motivated him. I am using the word very carefully. Sir, write your autobiography. I indicated to him there will be secretarial assistance. But now, ladies and gentlemen, with your permission, we will force him to write his memoirs. one of our finest officials, Dr. Vandana Kumar, will coordinate with her daughter, his daughter. We need to know it. डॉक्टर साहब को कहो मदद क्या चाहिए, इनकी जबान हिलती नहीं है। जिस संस्था को आपने इतना योगदान किया है, इतना जीवन दिया है, आप लिखिए जो बात आपके दिल से निकलेगी वो दिल से नहीं, दिल से, दिमाग से और आत्मा से निकलेगी। आप जो कहेंगे उसका असर पीढ़ियों पर पड़ेगा। यदि अगर आप इनकी किताबों का देखेंगे, मैं इनकी किताबें बहुत काम में लेता हूँ। पार्लियामेंट की विट एंड ह्यूमर के बारे में इनकी किताब देखिए आप, उनसे प्रेरित होकर मैं भी पार्लियामेंट को कुछ गुड ह्यूमर में रखने की कोशिश करता हूँ। आप किसी भी कालखंड में देखिए, कुछ लोग छाप छोड़ देते हैं। 2015 का वो दिन, 14 के अंदर 3 दशक के बाद कोलिशन गवर्नेंस का अंत हुआ। 2015 में द नेशन कन्फर्ड ऑन डॉक्टर सुभाष कश्यप सिविलियन अवार्ड, भारत पद्म भूषण, वेल अर्न्ड, वेल रिकग्नाइज्ड। पर उस अलंकरण का भी इन पर असर नहीं। डॉक्टर कश्यप, एंड आई नॉर्मली डोंट से फॉर लिविंग मोर्टल्स, आई डोंट एलिवेट अ लिविंग मोर्टल टू दैट स्टेटस, but then there are some, he has ceased to be an individual, he is an institution. Coming to his latest but not last work, on which Dr. Swati has reflected enough, I take you to the Indian Constitution. That constitution in which Nandlal Bose in West Bengal had the occasion to contribute, it is handwritten. It has 22 miniatures, mini paintings. With reference to these two books, one in Hindi, the other in English, part 4 of the Indian Constitution pertaining to directive principles of state policy. वहाँ क्या चित्र है? भगवान श्री कृष्ण कुरुक्षेत्र की भूमि में अर्जुन को गीता का उपदेश दे रहे हैं। When in doubt, when of two minds, when in the Macbeth syndrome, to be or not to be, you have a light at the end of that tunnel, and that light is flickering from Gita. Gita teaches you sublimity, spirituality, religiosity, commitment to your duty, distancing yourself from self. The greatest problem for human mind is we are self-conscious. I am avoiding the word selfish. And this self-interest is coming in the way of we being real servants of Bharat. We have to ensure every moment we keep the interest of our nation uppermost. Sorry. There can be no interest above the nation. When I speak of Dr. Kashyap writing his memoirs, he knows what happened in early 50s. He knows my plight as a member of parliament, as a union minister in 1990. Friends, you'll be surprised. In 1990, the size of economy of Bharat was smaller than that of city of London and Paris. In 1990, सोने की चिड़िया कहलाने वाले देश का सोना हवाई जहाज में रखा गया, स्विट्जरलैंड के दो बैंकों को प्लेज किया गया ताकि हम आर्थिक क्रेडिबिलिटी को मेंटेन कर पाए। हमने पीड़ा देखी 1990 में, जब जम्मू कश्मीर गया, सेंट्रल होटल में रुका, सन्नाटा चारों तरफ, डेथली साइलेंस। मैंने मंत्री की हैसियत से देखा, हमें बताते थे वर्ल्ड बॉडीज, वर्ल्ड बैंक, IMF, हाउ टू कंडक्ट आवर अफेयर्स। कहाँ थे, कहाँ आ गए? पेरिस और लंदन से छोटी साइज की इकोनॉमी हमारी आज फ्रांस, UK, कनाडा, ब्राजील से आगे हैं, हम पांचवें नंबर हैं। दो साल में जर्मनी और जापान भी पीछे रह जाएंगे। जब सोना गिरवी रखा था तो फॉरेन एक्सचेंज 1 बिलियन के इधर उधर डोल रहा था, आज 600 बिलियन से ऊपर है। कहाँ आ गए? जिस कश्मीर में उस समय हम गए थे, सेंट्रल होटल में रुके थे, सन्नाटा था, उसने अप्रत्याशित संख्या में टूरिस्ट को देखा है। यू कांट फिगर आउट द नंबर इन मिलियंस, ऐसा पहले कभी नहीं हुआ। जो IMF, वर्ल्ड बैंक कहते थे आप ये करो वो करो, आज दुनिया को कहते हैं वो करो जो भारत कर रहा है। वी आर फेवरेट डेस्टिनेशन, ग्लोबल डेस्टिनेशन ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटी। ये जो 360 डिग्री टर्न है, ये डॉक्टर सुभाष कश्यप ने अपनी आंखों से देखा है, महसूस किया है। ऐसे व्यक्ति हैं जिन्होंने 1990 तक कितने प्रधानमंत्री देखे हैं, कितने गवर्नेंस देखी हैं, और बाद में आने वाले प्रधानमंत्री और वर्तमान प्रधानमंत्री का कितना आदर करते हैं, ये मैं इनको बता चुका हूँ। वो राष्ट्रपति निवास में आए तभी बता चुका हूँ, डॉक्टर कश्यप जी हम आपके कायल हैं, आप कलम को चलाइए, मेमोज को लिख दीजिए, डॉक्टर वंदना कुमार से बेटर, सशक्त, हिम्मत आपको और कहीं नहीं मिल सकती। आपकी बेटी स्वाति और वंदना जी जो आपकी बेटी के समकक्ष है, 1 और 11 होंगे। प्लीज डू इट। थैंक यू सो मच।
Thank you, sir, for your valuable insights. We now come to the much-awaited moment of today's program. May I request the Honorable Vice President of India to release Srimad Bhagavad Gita, a commentary by Dr. Subhash C. Kashyap. May I request Dr. Swati Kashyap ji and Renu Kaul Verma ji to kindly join us. Thank you, sir. With that, we come to the conclusion of today's program. May I for the national anthem.
व्यक्ति के जीवन में रोशनी और आशा का प्रवाह होगा।
I request all guests to kindly remain seated.